So very good morning to all of you. As we have already started doing tenses, last week we completed simple present or present indefinite tense along with present continuous tense. So this week we'll be completing present tense, present perfect tense and perfect continuous. So keep your pens and notebooks ready with you. Take notes, beta. Firstly, I'll be telling you why we call it present perfect tense. Clear? My voice is audible to everyone? Okay. Now it will be better, I guess. So, why we call it present perfect tense? Firstly, I'm going to tell. When an action is completed perfectly, because I already told you that tenses are all about completion of the action and the time of completion. Fine. So when in this case, action has just been completed, clear? Perfectly, it is done. That's why the name of the tense is present perfect. The action is done, completed, work is done in this case. That's why we name it present perfect tense, clear? So now after telling you why it is named so, we'll be doing uses of present perfect tense. First uses, there are n number of uses, but we'll be doing which are the quite oftenly used. Here, first one is when action has been completed. When action, note down with a, when action has been completed clear. So, or you can say recently also, or in the recent past. Clear? Recently, if it is done, or in the recent past. Clear? Then we use present perfect tense. For example, firstly, just let's write the uses, fine, and then we'll be doing rule and then example. Clear? First use is clear to you. Now, second use. Where do we use this tense? When you talk in English, most of the time, we start thinking in Hindi first, then we convert it into English, and then we try to speak, but we end up with incorrect English. So if the child directly thinks in English, and who can think in English directly? The person who knows what is the usage of particular tense, number one. Number two, a person who quite oftenly uses English language while speaking with others. And thirdly, your vocabulary should be strong enough. Fine. If you know tenses, your vocabulary is quite strong. And then you'll be able to, you can say, speak fluently. Okay. So you should quite oftenly talk in English with whosoever is possible to you. When action has been completed, number one is done. Now, second is when you talk about a past experience. Fine. While talking about past experience, while talking about past experience. Now, past experience, as if you ask your friend, you're talking to your friend, you're saying, have you been to Delhi? Fine. Have you gone, you can say, have you been to Delhi? Have you seen this movie, any movie? Have you seen, have you played, you can say, PS4, you say PlayStation and all. Fine, in that way. So you're just asking about past experience in that. Clear? Then we use this perfect tense. Many uses are there again. See, many students are joining later. So, I'll be focusing on two uses only in this case. There are a number of uses, but mainly I'll be focusing on these two. When action has been completed and when we talk about some past experience. Fine, now let's do the rules. Rules now. It's very easy. We use has or have plus V3. Clear? Now one golden rule I'm going to tell you, which applies on all the perfect tenses. When you'll be doing present perfect, when you'll be doing past perfect, or when you'll be doing future perfect, fine? Always in perfect tense, we use V3. That is third form of the verb. Clear? No V1, no V2 is used in this. Third form of verb is used always in the perfect tenses. Clear? So that way you can recall easily which form of verb to be used. So the rule says, has or have, one out of the two. Clear? Has or have plus V3. Has or have plus V3. Clear? Now, where to use has and where to use have? That is quite easy. With he, she, it, and singulars, we use has. Singular is one person. Clear? And where to use have? Have is used with, beta, you remember we have done in present simple tense, we have done this. Same list applies. We have done, where do we use does and where do we use do? Same list is there. Like in the case of does, we use he, she, it, and singular. In the case of do, we use I, we, you, they, or plural, we can say, fine. So in the same way, same list is there. You need not, it's not a new list of pronouns or nouns. Clear? Only you should know where we use has and where we use have. Clear? I, we, you, they, and plurals. Plural here means two or more than two. If I talk about two students, then I'll be using plural. If I say Ram and Ria have completed their project. Two names means plural. Clear? If I talk about Ria has completed her project. Clear? So very easy it is. Just you need to learn that where we use has and where we use have. Clear? Once you learn, and once you start using this in your speech, it will be very easy for you to speak in between. Clear? So now, is it clear to all of you? Send me thumbs up. Come on, interact. I have not yet opened that text box. You won't be able to text me. Okay, you're getting it. Very good. Now I'll be unmuting the students. Now let's do the unmuting. You will be giving me examples. We have done tenses n number of times, many a time. So you will be giving me examples. I'll be writing here for you. And let's talk about first, before asking you, let me tell you about negative and interrogative sentences also. This is the positive or affirmative sentence which we have done. When you are supposed to use a not in a sentence, that becomes negative. So where do we use not? Exactly after the helping verbs, exactly after has or have. Clear? So that is the place where we insert not. If I say Ria has not completed her project. Ria and Rahul have not completed their project. Clear? In case of negative sentences, we just add not after has or have. Clear? This is also another golden rule. First golden rule was V3 is used in all the perfect tenses. Second golden rule is position of not. not always comes after the helping verbs. You need to note it down. Not always comes after the helping verbs, because here two helping verbs are two only, has and have. But when you will be doing next tense, that is present perfect continuous tense, then you people get confused. Many students, they start writing has been, not have been, not, then it will be a big cross. You're supposed to write has not been, have not been. So that golden rule of using not will help you here. Okay, beta? So now I'll be unmuting. Not is clear to where to use not. Is it clear to you? Okay, now interrogative sentences. In interrogative sentences, the position of has and have will be before subject. Subject is about which we are talking about. If I say, has Riya completed the project? Have Rahul and Riya completed the project? In that way, position of has and have comes at the first place. Then comes the subject and then rest of the structure of the sentence. Okay, beta? Now, don't give me the example which I have given you about Riya and Rahul and projects and all. Think something novel, something new. Just make one new sentence by using has and have. And I'm giving you a choice. Either you can make a negative sentence, interrogative, or affirmative. That is your choice. Fine, but I just want present perfect to be used. So let's start. Raise your hands, those who want to give examples of present perfect tense. Very easy it is. Raise your hands, beta. Example of present perfect tense. Same students I don't want. Titiksha has raised hand. Now, daily basis, same students are coming. Otherwise, I will choose any of you. And the one who will not be answering. Okay, Bhavansh. Unmute yourself, Bhavansh. Bhavansh, you can unmute yourself, beta. Not able to? Bhavansh, firstly unmute yourself and then speak. Yes, speak now. You chose the wrong option. You're unable to unmute, I guess. Who wants to answer next? Khyati, unmute yourself, beta. Khyati, you have raised hand. Can you hear me? Khyati, unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Khyati, beta, give me one
example. He has finished his homework.
Please repeat.
He has finished his homework.
He has
finished his homework.
You have replaced word project with homework. I'm just saying, give me some new example. That's good. Very good that you have tried a lot, but I want a new sentence in which you are not going
she...
to... Yes. Speak, beta, Khyati.
She has forgotten her folder.
She has forgotten her
folder.
Folder. Okay. So right answer, beta. Very good. Well done. You can mute yourself, Khyati. Very good. Now it's turn for. Now, firstly, listen to me. I want one interrogative sentence now. Interrogative sentence with present perfect. Okay, Lisa, unmute yourself, Lisa.
Yes, ma'am. Has she completed her work?
Wow. I'm saying that don't use the same sentence, completed work, projects and all. Something new. Anyone else? Aryan, unmute yourself. Yes, beta.
Has he eaten the apples?
Has she written the
Ma'am, has he eaten the apples?
Has? I'm not able to listen to you clearly, Aryan. Can you repeat, beta?
Has he eaten the apples?
Have we eaten the apples? Okay, beta. So this is also correct. You can mute yourself, Aryan. Fine. Okay. Now you got it. Okay, let's continue, beta, now with next tense. So you got how to make examples out of it, how to use it in your daily life. Clear? So when action is completed, then we use present perfect tense. Now let's continue with present perfect continuous tense. Present perfect continuous tense. Spelling of continuous should be correct, beta. Most of the students, they write wrong spelling. Fine. Continuous and U-O-U-S. Present perfect continuous tense. Now we'll be firstly writing the uses. Mainly one usage we'll be doing in this, which is the foremost. So in this, present perfect continuous tense, it is used to describe an action that started in the past . See by seeing the name you will be clear. Present perfect says when action is completed, it means action is already started. Continuous tense is used when some action is continued at the time of speaking. Clear? So this is the mixture of two tenses. When action is already there and it is continued in the future also. Clear? So that's why we use present perfect continuous tense. Two things are mixed up here. Don't get confused. It is used to describe an action that started in the past and is still continuing in the future. Is it visible to you? Screen is visible. Continued in the continuing in the future. Continuing in the present or maybe extended to the future. Clear? So it does not mean ki at the time of speaking only and that's it. Maybe it can be extended in the future also. Continuing in the present or maybe extended in the future. Now, I'll give you one basic example. Suppose a building is into the construction is going on nearby your house. And you see that laborers are working day and night to complete the building. So you are observing one of them who has been working, you can say, for a longer span of time. Clear? Action started in the past. He started working in the morning and it's afternoon and still he's working. The action started in the past, but it still continued. And maybe he will be working till night because they have continuous hours, you can say. He's supposed to complete the building. So in that case, you can say the laborers have been working since morning. Clear? The laborers have been working. It's B-E-E-N. I'll be making you write the rule. You need not worry about it, beta. I'm just discussing one example to make you understand the use. Clear? An action which started in the past but still continuing in the present and maybe extended to the future also. Clear? Laborers have been working since morning. Or if you want to, you'll be using since and for also in this. That I'll be telling you. So step by step, we are learning. Clear? Firstly, use is clear to you. Now we will be doing rule. Rule is has been or have been plus, okay, one out of the two, either has been or have been, and that list remains the same. Where to use has been and where to use have been, it is same. Only you have added been over here. Clear? That list remains same. Only you need to add been over there. Now, has been or have been plus V1 plus ing plus since or for. Note down very carefully. You need not miss anything in it. Fine. If you miss anything, you won't be able to. Don't get scared after seeing, oh my God, ma'am has written such a big rule. What is since? What is for? I'll be explaining each and every part of it. Okay, so don't get worried. Only just take notes first of the rule has been slash have been. One out of the two plus V1 plus ing plus since or for. Now, before writing example, I'll be making you understand important concept, that is where to use since and where to use for. Even students after completing plus two, they start using, you can say, wrongly. They are not able to use either since or for. But when I'll be asking question, Brijesh, then you will raise hand. Otherwise, you need not. Clear? The students who are raising hands in between, when I'm speaking, in between you start raising hands and start asking which question to do in the notebook, and all these questions are not meant to be answered now. Let me continue with the subject matter first. I'll be giving you time at the end when we'll discuss exercises, then I'll be explaining to you. Okay? So don't raise hands in between. That is a distraction for the teacher to continue. Clear? So has been, you know, he, she, it, and singulars, and have been, I, we, you, they, and plurals. You need to learn it. I'll be asking you next time when we'll be doing tenses. Firstly, I'll be asking you rules. I'll be picking up one period just to ask you the rule of this thing, example of that thing in that way, so that I can know you have learned it exactly. By understanding, not cramming. There is no need to cram anything in it. You need to understand the concept. We have done it in a, you can say, deeper way. Okay. Now, the question is where to use since and where to use for. We'll be using since. You have done in junior classes also, I know. Many of you might be knowing it also. But even then, when we revise things, they become permanent in our memories. Since is used when point of time is given. Exact point of time. Now, what do you mean by exact point of time? If I talk about, I have been working harder since Monday. I talk about exact point. I talk about Monday. I talk about 9 o'clock. I talk about March. I talk about, you can say 8 o'clock. Fine. If I talk about exact day or exact time or exact month, clear? Then we use since when exact point of time is given. For your convenience, you can write down in the bracket also. Monday, It doesn't mean only Monday. It means every week, any day of the week. I'm just giving you for example sake. Monday, 4 o'clock means exact point of time is given, exact month is given, exact year is given. Like COVID-19 has been spreading since 2020. See, example. Clear? COVID-19 has been spreading since 2020. Clear? And it started in the past. It's present also today. Clear? We all are facing it. That's why people are sitting at home and I'm teaching via computer. Clear? And it is, or maybe it will be continuing in the future. It is already extended, you know that. We never know when it's going to end. Clear? But exact year is given to us, 2020 in India, you can say. Last year in March it started, if you remember. Clear? So, now, for. Where we use for now, when period of time is given. When period of time is given. Okay? Period of time now. What do you mean by period of time? Take notes. I'll be seeing your notebooks. Come on fast. Period of time. When a longer period is given. Suppose I talk about, I have been teaching you for 40 minutes, for 35 minutes. A span is given. Clear? You have been attending English classes for 2 weeks. A span or duration is given. Clear? He has been, you can say, crying with the pain for 2 hours. Clear? We have been, suppose you are living in a house since so many years. Fine, if you tell, very easy example I give you. Suppose you built your house in year 2018. We have been living in this house for 3 years. Clear? You're talking about years. You're not talking about the exact year. If you say, we have been living in this house since 2018. If you give the year exact point, then you'll be using since. If you will be giving span or period, that how long it is, then for. Anybody who has doubt, you can ask me now. Send me thumbs up if it's clear to you. I'll be moving up to next. Discussing exercises, which you might have completed. Okay. Well done, beta. Okay, it's clear to you. Now you will be giving me answers of the exercises I have already given you. My page is 182 in the grammar book, but some students were telling me the page number is different in their books. So you can open accordingly. You just go to tenses and exercise one. Only one exercise is given. Clear? So you'll be answering me accordingly. Okay, beta? Those who have done kindly. Yes, raise your hand. I'm going to open the option to send the answers also, if you want to write. Clear? Now you can send me via message also. So exercise one in the grammar book. Yes, those who have done, kindly answer. Okay, bell has gone. We are supposed to finish this off now. So, your homework is exercise 3, exercise 4, and exercise 5. Exercise 5 is based on all the kinds of present tenses, indefinite, continuous, perfect, as well as perfect continuous. Clear? So, next session, we'll be discussing the answers. Clear? Exercise 1 and 2 you have already done. 3, 4 and 5 you are supposed to do. In the grammar book directly, you need not write it. You can note down these rules in your peer notebook. Clear? And you're supposed to appear for the text next Saturday. Okay, beta? I'll be putting the details in the group. Till then, keep studying and keep learning. Okay, beta?